time we start a new vehicle design, surprisingly, we don't start with the motor, we don't start with the person, we don't start with the chassis, we always start with the tire. The reason we start with the tire is we know that's the only thing that contacts the ground, and we know for sure that's a product we're gonna buy off the shelf. So we always design the vehicle to make the best utilization of the tire, since it's the only contact we have with the ground. So we wanna balance the size, the weight, the cost of the tire with the power, the performance, and the terrain that the vehicle is designed to operate in. With our motorcycle weighing half the weight of a typical motorcycle, we found that the traditional dirt bike tires were not a good fit for us. The sidewall is too stiff, so the tire wasn't cushioning enough and making good contact with the ground. In addition, the weight of the tire was too heavy. So we had to be really creative and really thoughtful about how we choose the right tires for this new class of motorcycle that's half the weight of a traditional motorcycle. For close to the last 9 years, I've been experimenting with different tires on my electric motorcycles. Over the years, I initially started with mountain bike tires, and as the motorcycles have gotten heavier and less like a bicycle and more like a motorcycle, we've started working with motorcycle tires. We've probably gone through 15 or 20 different tires in testing. We're really looking for that balance between maximum traction, great handling, puncture protection, lightweight, and most importantly for electric vehicles, low rolling resistance. With our EL12 motorcycle, we settled on a 21-21 inch wheel size with 80 millimeter rear tire and a 2.75 front tire, typically designed for the front of a motorcycle. So we utilize two front tires on the EL12. That gives us low rolling resistance, amazing traction, lightweight, and very free and adjustable handling. So the vehicle doesn't feel heavy. You can still flick it around, but you still have the traction to harness all of the torque that we make. Once we had chosen the right tires, we needed to select a suitable rim. We've spent years trying different rims from different makers, aluminum rims from Excel, a lot of the leading brands. And we settled on utilizing a carbon fiber off-road rim laced to our very own specific spoke nipples and our own custom hub. So that was the beginning of the wheel package. Once we had the wheel package, then we started designing the vehicle from there out. So we thought about what is the right wheelbase for this type of vehicle. So here we have the traditional motorcycle wheel, motocross wheel. This is an 18-inch wheel that you would typically find on the rear of a motocross bike. This happens to be a Trials compound tire, but traditional size 18-inch. This is the 21-inch wheel that we utilize for our EL12 factory team edition, in addition with the carbon fiber rim, our oversized aluminum head, aluminum spoke nipples, and the custom graft hub. So what we were able to realize is that by utilizing this taller 21-inch tire, we're able to reduce the rolling resistance while also maintaining the same level of traction that the wider tire offered us. This slightly narrower tire with, you know, more aggressive lug pattern offers all the hill climb torque you could ever need while allowing us to get longer range on one battery. So instead of going with kind of the traditional wide 18-inch wheel, we're going a little bit narrower and taller diameter. We reduce that rolling resistance going over obstacles, allows for a longer ride, but still offers all the traction you might demand. Here's a traditional 200 millimeter 1.8 millimeter thick bicycle brake rotor. This is industry standard stainless steel. And this is what you'll see on typical electric motorcycles in our category. While this offers okay brake performance, we decided to go with a unique 250 millimeter rotor. Not only is it 250 millimeters, it's 2.3 millimeters thick. So we have quite an increase in braking performance. We have almost 50% improved braking performance over the industry standard. And this really is a good suit for our electric motorcycles, which are a little bit heavier than a mountain bike, but still quite a bit lighter than a motorcycle. So this is the Graft rear hub, our pin drive hub. Again, we're deviating from standard bicycle parts. We manufacture our own hubs in-house. What we've done with this hub is we're able to create what's called a zero dish wheel. So the spokes are symmetric compared to most motorcycle and bicycle spokes where we see the spokes are asymmetric. This gives us more strength and a lighter weight. In addition, with this hub, we're able to offer a pin drive interface for our sprocket to ensure that we can transfer the tremendous torque that our motors generate. This hub is ultra lightweight, and then we also have our torque shell design, which transfers the torque across the hub so that we're applying torque at the left and right side through the spokes equally. Unlike most traditional electric motorcycles or even bicycles in the market, the Graft EL12 Factory Team Edition, you'll notice this extra nut. This extra nut is hiding what's called a rim lock. This rim lock is needed to lock the tire to the rim. Our motorcycle makes so much torque and we run the tires at such low pressure that we can actually have the tire spin on the rim. So we're one of the only companies to offer rim locks as standard, so that it locks your tire directly to the rim. You have no spinning of the tire on the rim. And it also allows you to run ultra low tire pressures for those slippery days. We can run tire pressure as low as 2 PSI, even 1 PSI on wet, slippery days. One of the things we're really proud of at Graft is our very unique suspension. Working with Olivier Bassard at the team in BOS, we have a unique front fork. We're the only electric vehicle in the market to offer this fork, where most of our competitors are offering 38 millimeter forks. A few aftermarket companies may even have a 40 millimeter fork. Our fork boasts 42 millimeter legs that give you increased stiffness at lighter weight and a full 48 millimeter upper body. This is proportional to what you see on a full motocross fork. In addition, these 42 millimeter legs, along with the carbon fiber rim and our unique zero dish hub, mean you have a very stiff front end, which allows you to pick your line very, very specifically and carefully, but we still offer the very light weight that many of our competitors struggle with. So we're continuing to work and do testing on our ATV. Like any vehicle at Graft, when we start the design of this vehicle, we start with the tires. For this vehicle, we initially started with a variety of different tires and then we narrowed it down to a few candidates. We're currently testing with the 16-inch motocross tires. Initial results are looking pretty good. We were a little bit concerned about flotation in soft terrain such as sand, and we're seeing good results there. Hard ground, we have excellent traction in hard ground. And most importantly, we have a very light steering feel, which is really important on ATVs.